Welcome to the Beam Corner channel. I'm Chris from learngrasshopper.com. In this series, I'm presenting Grasshopper tips and tricks. Every software has this kind of Easter eggs, and so does Grasshopper. In this video, I want to show you some that you might not have found yet. Do you doubt it? You need to check this out. Did you know that some elements in Grasshopper can have two different functions? Let's start from the first element, which is the point. In this exercise, we are going to create the circle based on our point. In other words, we are going to create the circle where the center is based on our point. To do that, we are going to use create circle component. This component has plane as an input and radius. To create the plane, we need to use component xy plane, which needs a origin. Origin, it will be in our case the point. In that way, we connect plane to the component and we have created our circle. But actually, we can skip the step by creating the plane. Connecting automatically point to the plane, Grasshopper will create the plane XY. So in this way, we can avoid one component. The next element, which has two functions, is the line. In this exercise, we are going to move the circle from the one point to another. To do that, we are going to use move component, which needs motion. In this case, motion will be a vector, and the vector we can easily define by the point A, starting point, and point B, ending point. In green color, I can visualize how this vector looks like. So now we are using move component. We are connecting our circle to geometry, and motion, it will be our vector. But actually, we can use our line to the motion, because line is defined in the same way as a vector. We need the starting point and the ending point. So in lots of situations, you can use just a line instead of creating new vector. All right, and the third element is a plane. Plane has also another function, and it can be a surface. When we connect plane to the surface, it will create a B-wrap. So this B-wrap can we deconstruct and see all the faces or edges. Let's see how it looks like. When we zoom it to this surface, it will be like square element 1 × 1. If you would like to learn and read more about Grasshopper, I have prepared a free Grasshopper guide. 20 pages filled with books, exercises, and tutorials about Grasshopper. Everyone will find something for themselves. To download the guide, please click the link in the description below. There is a quick way to set up the default number in your component. Just double click on your canvas, choose your component from the list, put an equal sign and then default value. So for example, in base would be put 50. You can use this with the, for example, component P as a default value, or for example, with the sinus. Just choose the sin from the component list, put the equal sign and 30, and then the value will be set up. This method works with also different components like divide curve, and you can define a count number by 20. In circle component, for example, you can write 50 divided by 2, and in this way you put 25 in the radius. This method works also with mathematical component. So if you put plus 50, the B value as an input, it will be 50. Next one, fast calculations. When you double click on your canvas, you can actually write equations. So for example, 20 plus 20, you will get the slider with the 40 value. You can write your complicated equation and get in really quick way your slider. Even you can write more complicated ones with all the brackets and all the mathematical rules. And then in the end, you will get the result of the equation. Multi-wiring. If you need to plug in one wire into multiple components, you can do so by right-clicking instead of releasing the left mouse button when plugging in a wire. Let's check out the example. So, hold your left mouse button and click the right button. In that way, you can easily and in a really fast way connect one wire into several inputs. Hold your left mouse button and click right one. And last but not least, minus value. It's hard to tell how many times I have tried to write minus value in my canvas. Always subtraction component came along. And every time when I want to get negative value, I need to use negative component or go to the properties of the slider and change the value to minus by hand. But actually, it can be done much easier. When you go to canvas, double click, write your minus value and then double dot. In this easy way, you get minus value. Pretty cool, huh?
That's all for today. I hope you guys found these tips really helpful. If you like this video and want to see more in Grasshopper Tips and Tricks series, please click the like button and subscribe to this channel and to our Grasshopper newsletter, learngrasshopper.com. In this way, you will stay updated and learn Grasshopper regularly. Thanks for watching, see you next time. Have a good one.